Olympic pole vaulting bronze medalist Eliza McCartney was a very special guest of honour this morning at Belmont Intermediate, her old school in Auckland's Takapuna. The pupils were delighted to see her as they sat in the school assembly hall where Eliza herself sat only 7 years ago. Her rise, literally to 4.8 metres and a bronze medal, and more generally as the sudden recipient of considerable public admiration and affection, is still a source of wonder for the 19-year-old herself. After the assembly finished, I sat down with her in the Belmont Intermediate School Hall.
Eliza, have you been home yet?
No, I have not. Not for like 2 months.
So did you just land this morning?
I did, only a few hours ago.
And how many? I've been told by Scott out there that I'm interview number 7.
Oh, okay. I've been counting. There's been a few.
And probably interview number 700 since Rio, and yet I've been watching you. The same joy and delight and sense of possibility. It's a lovely quality. And it shone in Rio. You were so happy, weren't you?
I was. That's what I feel so proud about, is that, one, that I just enjoyed it so much, and two, that I genuinely can say I did everything I could, and that's not something you can say too often. I think I just did absolutely everything I could, and I enjoyed it, so that's what I'm most happiest about.
And to enjoy it on that stage, you know, I mean, there is no more global stage for a pole vaulter, for a 19-year-old athlete, to be on than the Olympics. And you didn't get overwhelmed in any way, did you?
I guess not. I think I did quite well there. I've just had a crazy year this year. My technique has just broken through, and that's why there's been such a huge jump in the heights that I've been achieving. But yeah, this year's been crazy. It's just building and building, and suddenly everyone's just so excited, and it's just awesome.
You talk about the heights, 4.8, which is a PB, and that's what you did at Rio. It's fantastic to do your PB at the Olympics, isn't it?
Yeah.
But there's a sense you can go higher, isn't there?
Hopefully, yes. I mean, I wasn't on my full run-up. I was basically on the full run-up. It was what worked at the time for this year, so that's what we went with. But I certainly can go on to a longer run-up. I certainly can get onto bigger poles, and I've not nailed the technique whatsoever. So I think it's just so exciting, especially with Jeremy. He's just such a wonder coach that I think hopefully we'll be pushing more heights soon.
Jeremy's standing out there. You went to Jeremy when you were 14 and said, I'd like to give this pole vaulting a go.
Yeah, I guess so. It seems like a long time ago now, but I guess it was only about 6 years.
Jeremy, by the wonders of editing, we have just left our interview with Eliza mid-interview and ducked out to grab you because she's talking about you with such gratitude and affection. Do you remember when she arrived as a 14-year-old and said, I wouldn't mind giving pole vaulting a go?
Yeah, absolutely. It's 6 years ago now, and you know, she's come on so well. You know, she was a skinny little kid back then, and she had great feel for the event.
She's got character, hasn't she? I mean, this is a kind of a Cinderella story. You know, she's come from nowhere in terms of the public sense of her, and she's got bronze in Rio, but actually there have been tough times, right? There have been times where she's had to really work hard to overcome things.
Yeah, absolutely. 2 years ago she was struggling to take off in pole vault. There was a few things that were happening that, you know, just were a little bit out of her control, but she's worked through those, and look where she's at now.
Yeah, it's pretty great, isn't it?
It is amazing, yeah. It's been 6 years, it's been a journey, and she's just been such an awesome athlete to work with.
Eliza, I was looking on your Instagram, and there's this beautiful thing, heart thumping. Was it? Could you feel it? Could you absolutely feel it?
That's 100% true. You know, I was actually lying in bed that night, like, trying to sleep, and I was thinking, like, that's just all I can remember, is that my heart was just... You know, you get those moments where you can just feel your whole body thumping with your heart, and that while I was watching the Australian girl do her last attempt, my heart was just going crazy. That's all I can remember, just going, oh, my gosh, I don't even know if I should watch. I don't even know what to do right now.
And you were looking out in the crowd in Rio, Brazil, and you were seeing your family there, right?
Yes, just so special. And even the qualifier, same thing. And I can hear them. I can hear them shouting. It's just, that's what's so amazing, just having everybody important to me right there. My family, my coach, my whole support team, so my physio, my doctor, everybody was just there. And that's what's so awesome, to share it with everybody.
What could you hear them shouting?
I could just, I don't know, just everything. Just go, Eliza, and just and hear them clapping and cheering when I jumped. And I, every time, I think you can see it when I clear a jump, I jump off, I fall on the mat and I look straight at the crowd. I'm like, yay, straight looking at my family.
What are you going to do for the next few days? I mean, you've been so generous with the media and with the people of New Zealand, but you need to stop now, don't you? Actually, just need to have a little bit of a break.
Yeah, my cheeks are really sore from smiling so much. I think what I'm going to do is just go and see everybody. I mean, I'm such a home girl. I love being in New Zealand, and I haven't seen everybody in so long. This is the longest I've ever been away from New Zealand in my home before, so that's what I'm really looking forward to. The next couple of days, just taking some time off and going to see everybody.
Enjoy it, Eliza, and congratulations.
Thank you so much.